This song's to feature our two of our saxophone players here, Larry Mett and Andy Hughes on tenor saxophone. And we have borrowed a couple of students from our school across the street from the law school. Let's see if Washington is good.
Someone good, though.
It's nice every 2 years to be here in privilege to have the law students. Thank you.
this year in her dedication to working on the music and sounding good and attitude on the alto saxophone, Carly Levin. I mentioned her name a moment ago, but let me take a moment to just say how happy I've been for these years that Amanda has been a part of the saxophone section. And she doesn't just anchor it from the top or the bottom. She anchors it from within. She's played lead alto. She's played tenor. She's even played in my trumpet section when I needed her back there. I can count on her to do anything. And if there comes to be a hole in an arrangement and we're not sure what to do with it, I can just point to her and say, Amanda, take a solo. And I can always count on it being good. Amanda Hughes on the tenor saxophone. We started out this semester with four saxophones, the fourth saxophone being, I introduced you a moment ago from the law school, Matt Morrison. Happy to have him here, not just for his alto saxophone ability, but for those of you that are fans of big band music, you know that clarinet is frequently an important component, and he's a wonderful clarinet player, and you'll get to hear him do some of that, Matt Morrison. And then we're moving along with four saxophones, and we needed an extra one, and I'll talk about these guys and the trumpets a bit later, but they said, hey, we've got a friend that would love to play, and he's pretty good. And so we said, bring him on, and we'll see, and he is, and we're happy to have him here, one of our borrowings from the high school here, and playing well above his age is Ben Simons on the tenor saxophone. So there's our saxophone. You'll meet everybody before we get out of here. But now, the Borjibu, or Iyakamabi.
Thank you.
Thank you. That piece, in addition to the saxophones on the wonderful ensemble, featured on the trumpet David Klinger. And as I'm talking about the trumpet section here, let me say a few words about them. David Klinger also has been in the band for a number of years. About, what is it now? 5, 6, 8 years? I wish we could fail these people so they would be in the band year after year after year, but sadly we just get them for about 4 years here. But happily we get them for 4 years as well. David's also one of those musicians that I can just point to and say, "Dave, take a solo." He's, "Sure." And he's got the trumpet up, and it's always something exciting to hear and fun to listen to. So on the trumpet, David Klinger. And for a semester there, the trumpet section was David Klinger. And then word got out. I got a phone call from somebody who said, "Hey, my name's Marty. I hear you're looking for some trumpet players." And I said, "Yeah, are you any good?" And he said, "Yeah." And but it's not that I took his word for it, because I'd asked his mom, too. And anyway, so Marty came along also from the high school and has contributed quite a lot. He was responsible, as I said, for letting Ben know about us being here, and he adds a lot both in his soloing and his lead player to the section, Marty Luce on the trumpet. And standing next to him, who adds definitely to the sound of the section, gives us that three voices that we can get those nice, fat, beautiful chords that you've been hearing and will continue to hear. Another hard work, and somebody I'm glad to have with us over here is Ryan Smut on the trumpet. And while I'm working down the back row here, might as well finish it off. Talk about people that don't graduate. But we couldn't fail him if we wanted, because we love him so much. He's been with the band in all sorts of capacities, with the wind ensemble and the orchestra, and just always there to play one of the 600 or 700 instruments that he has mastered. And happy to have him, as always, David Krantz on the trombone. Okay, back to the music. This is a great Duke Ellington tune called Mood Indigo.
Thank you.
Thank you. Beautiful song by a great American composer. Another great American composer and quite the character was a piano player, singer, songwriter named Fats Waller. Wrote hundreds and hundreds of great songs that are part of the repertoire today, get performed by everybody, and this next one's no exception. I'm sure you'll recognize the tune. What will be new to you will be the tasteful interpretation by the soloist on this, Amanda Hughes. This is Ain't Misbehavin'. Before we play the next selection in the on your scorecards that you have there, I'm going to insert a special number here. As many of you know, a couple of weeks ago, the Lenfest community, the Lexington community, and just the whole humanity committee community lost somebody very special to us, Michael Gorman. He was very close to all of us that worked here. He was very close to the people in the audience. I'm sure you saw him coming in and out of concerts and. It's hard to think of things going on around here without him, but as he was a show person from the day one, he would be the first to tell us that the show must go on, and on it does go in his memory and his spirit. When I first heard about this, I reacted like, I guess, the only way that a composer, arranger can do, and that was with music. I thought of a song that Irving Berlin had written back in 1912. He had just gotten married. His wife was 20 years old. And they went to Cuba for their honeymoon. And when they came back, she had caught something there that killed her very quickly and briefly. Very brief marriage, very brief life. And so he reacted the only way that he could, and that was with a song that he called When I Lost You. And so when this happened, I sat down a couple of nights later and wrote this arrangement that we're about to play for you of that Irving Berlin song. Before I do, I thought I'd read these words to you because they're just so simple and yet so beautiful. I lost the sunshine and roses. I lost the heavens of blue. I lost the beautiful rainbow. I lost the morning dew. I lost the angel who gave me the whole winter too. I lost the gladness that turned into sadness when I lost you. We'll miss you, Mike. Thank you. That was, of course, Glenn Miller's great theme song, Moonlight Serenade, and you heard Matt Morrison on the clarinet. All right, now for those of you that have been doing your swing dancing all weekend long and just dying to keep going a little bit, we're going to do a old Louis Prima piece. I expect to see bodies being tossed left and right on the dance floor on this. This is Jump Jive and Whale. This will feature Amanda and Marty. ¶¶ For the best couple on the floor of that dance. Right out here. We're going to play one more tune and then take a little break for you. This is a song that was originally a big hit for the Beboppers, Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie. Feel free to sing along if you'd like. It's called Salt Peanuts. Thank you. Well, we're going to come back out here and play a little bit more music before we get out of there. Was another hand for the wonderful rhythm section there. I should introduce them to you so you can know them, talk to them, meet them, become their best friends, all that kind of stuff. Another long mainstay with the band, he's also been with the band for 3 years or so, but Peter Jones on the bass. And you also heard, of course, you met earlier David Kranz and Amanda, who played on that piece as well. We got into a little jam here, and not the kind of jam where musicians play jazz tunes together, the kind of jam in that all of a sudden we found ourselves without a drummer. We were using a student from VMI, and they're on spring break this week. And he decided it would be more fun to go to Panama City and share a hotel room with 6 of his best friends. I asked him if I could come too, but he said no, that 6 was the maximum. So anyway, sort of a month or so ago when we discovered this, we scouted around. We didn't scout around. It was very easy. Amanda said, hey, I know somebody. He's pretty good. And he's a student here. I hadn't had the pleasure to meet him before, but I'm glad he's come along. He's added a lot to us. He's got a great attitude, good job on the drums with the solos and the ensemble. Meet Brendan Smith. And also in the rhythm section, which I'm particularly happy to have because it keeps frees me from having to walk all the way over to the piano as much to play the chords behind the band. And it adds a whole new element on the music we're going to play. You'll hear some solo up ahead before we get out of here tonight. Also a law student, first year law student, Clint Carpenter on the guitar. He's got a fan club, I can tell. We're going to move ahead now with one of the first big hits from a band that's real special to me, the Stan Kenton Band. This is Eager Beaver. One of the more avant-garde jazz composers from the 1950s and 1960s was the bass player Charles Mingus. Led a great, innovative band and always had music that was a little bit on the wild, exciting side. And I think this one you'll find to be no different. Name of the piece is Moanin'. And during the course of this, you will hear David Klinger on a trumpet solo, and you will hear the wonderful Ian Handerhan on the baritone saxophone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ann Handerhan and David Klinger on that one. Being a composer myself, I'm attracted to other wonderful composers and melodies and great songs out there. And this next one, I think, is written by one of the great songwriters, certainly the top bossa nova writer of all time, one of the great melodists, I think. And this is a beautiful, poignant, slow bossa nova called How Insensitive. Thank you. Another great composer in this next piece, and a great hit. One of the last great jazz pieces to actually be a top 10 hit back about 40 years ago. I invite you to come up and dance to this one in particular, if you can count to five. If you stop at three or four, you might have a little trouble, but give it a whirl anyway. This is the jazz take five. This will feature some duetting between Amanda Hughes and David Klinger.
Thank you, Amanda and David, once again. This next piece was written by a California writer, Matt Harris, who's written for a lot of the great contemporary big bands. This one is going to feature a whole mess of people back here. You'll hear, once again, Amanda Hughes, you'll hear Matt Morrison, and you'll hear Marty Luce and Dave Klinger getting wild back there on the trumpets together. C-Band, Stomp. Thank you. Another one of the my favorite composers. It's wonderful being in charge because I get to pick all the music I like. And this next composer, I think, is one of the most remarkable songwriters over the past half century. He's written so many great songs, most of them for a variety of movies, from The Summer of 42, Brian's Song, things like that. This particular song that we're about to do was from a musical that he did, that he wrote the music for. Barbara Streisand starred in it and sang this song. The movie was called Yentl, and the name of the song is The Way He Makes Me Feel. You will hear melodic statements in this from Amanda Hughes and from Marty, as well as the rest of the band in and out. It's a beautiful ballad with some great arranging by Dave Wolpe.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I've loved that song since I first heard it, as I do much of his compositions, Michel Legrand's compositions. We're going to conclude tonight with a couple of selections that both came from a musical. Doesn't quite date as far back as the George Gershwin's and that we've played before, but a wonderful piece of musical theater that not so long ago you may have seen performed on this very stage in the full production of the musical Hair. Very big musical back in the late 60s, and there's some wonderful songs from it that have crossed over into the pop music world. And we're going to do a couple of my favorites from that, starting with Good Morning Starshine, and we'll conclude right after that with the medley of Aquarius and Let the Sun Shine In. I should make a point before we do start this that you will get to hear once again the fabulous guitar playing at the end of Aquarius from Clint Carpenter. So here's a couple of tunes from Hair. I hope you enjoy it. And thank you very much for coming out tonight. Last Chances to Dance. Before we play our final song, I just want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. It's a busy time of year. I know spring is sprung, and there's so many things to do and drag you all sorts of fun places. I'm glad you chose tonight to be here with us to share this concert. It means a lot to us to have you out there tonight. So one final song, and we'll say goodnight. This is Aquarius. thank you, everybody. Thank you very much for coming out. Thanks to the dancers. Thank you very much. Good night.